Hello everybody, I'm Andy Lowe from Future Consideration, and today we'll take a closer look at two of the most promising and exciting prospects for the upcoming drafts, Jack Hughes and Alexis Lafrenière. While some might disagree, I believe Hughes and Lafrenière are currently both their respective drafts' clear-cut number one prospect, and many have even advanced to say that they are near-generational talent. Both top prospects might not have the same draft year, but hockey fans have been comparing them ever since they started lighting up their respective leagues last season, with both players making their national team roster for the upcoming World Junior Championship in Vancouver. I thought it would be a good idea to join the conversation and compare Hughes and Lafrenière. Let's start by looking at every aspect of their game. That means skating, shooting, passing, stick handling, defensive play, physicality, hockey IQ, and competitiveness. Let's immediately start with skating. Hughes is an amazing and complete skater. He has a tremendous speed and a great agility that allows him to pass defensemen like it's nothing. He has some slick edges that helps him move around the ice at his will and get a great balance. Not kidding, his edge work might be the best I've seen from any hockey player in the world. For many prospects, it's tough to get a lot of skating highlights, but for Hughes, he showcases generational skating on every shift. His quick turns and fluid stride are also a reason why I think Hughes has the potential to become the best complete skater of all time. McDavid got the speed, Hughes the agility. Lafrenière has an above average speed at best. Although he can get breakaway with his good hockey senses, he will never outskate someone. His agility is great and he got some quick turns. His edge work is also good, but let's just say it's quite far from Hughes' level. The American center gets an easy win on this one. Let's pass to their shooting. Hughes has an incredible release. He can get a shot to the net from any position and can even surprise some goalies with his quick release. He prefers to use his wrist shot than slap shot, and rightfully so, as he got a very accurate one. His shot could use a bit more power, but overall, it's already excellent. He currently got 10 goals in 25 games with the USNTDP U18 team. Lafrenière is a very complete goal scorer, as he can score from anywhere on the ice and with any type of shot. His release is just amazing. His snapshot can take him as low as 1.132 seconds to release, which is already NHL numbers. His wrist shot is precise and powerful. He loves to go short side, but will adapt to the goalie positioning. He also owns a good shot on reception. He can find holes in goalies in breakaway or score from tough angle in the offensive zone. Whatever you give to Lafrenière, he will gladly accept it and score on you. He currently got 17 goals in 31 QMJHL games. Lafrenière gets the win on this one. Let's continue and look at their passing. Hughes is an excellent passer. He has a great vision that allows him to find teammates around the ice easily. He seems to know where his linesmates are without even looking, and he's sometimes so confident in his passes that he will just look right in the opponent's eyes while distributing the puck. I would like to see him open the play more in the neutral zone, as he can sometimes be a bit of a puck hog trying to go end-to-end. He currently got 38 assists in 25 games with the USNTDP U18 team. Lafrenière is an amazing passer. I don't recall seeing a prospect with such a good vision at a young age like the Canadian winger. He can find teammates around the ice so easily and seamlessly. He creates so many scoring chances for his teammate and he opens the play so well. Lafrenière can start the play from the back end and finish it up front with just pro-level passes. He has currently 37 assists and 31 QMJHL games. Although Hughes is one of the best playmakers of the 2019 draft, Lafrenière is just on another level. He takes the win on this aspect. Let's now take a look at their stick handling. Hughes has some slick and fleshy hands that allows him to pull digs after digs and dangle everybody on the ice. His quick mitts and seamless puck handling makes him very tough to stop for any defenseman, and he can sometimes get alone in front of the net because of it. He makes many unnecessary turnovers trying too much digs, but when he does succeed his move, it pays off. Lafrenière also got a lot of skills. With his quick and slick hands, he can go through defensemen with ease and get great scoring chances out of it. He has the ability to just mystify everyone on the ice with incredible moves. He also adapts his move to the opponent positioning, which helps him become more effective. Lafrenière is able to create space for himself or dodge poke check along the board. It's a very close call, but I think I will have to give the edge to Hughes. A bit less effective right now, but more potential. Let's pass to their defensive game. Hughes is very focused on his offensive play, and sometimes forget to put effort to defend. With his good quickness, stick check and edges, Hughes has some defensive skills, but he isn't as involved as I would want. I don't think it's that much of a problem, but it's definitely one of his weaknesses. When the puck is recovered, he can restart the attack well with his passes and fluid skating, so he just needs to get more involved down low. Lafrenière got an active stick defensively, and with his great reading of the play, he blocks passing lane effectively. He backchecks most of the time and gets involved in board battles. Nothing special, but definitely a step ahead of Hughes in this category, so Lafrenière gets the nod. Let's now check out the physical aspect of the game. Hughes is 5'10 and weighs 168 pounds, while Lafrenière is 6'1 and weighs 192 pounds at the moment, according to Elite Prospect. On the ice, Hughes clearly lacks a bit of strength. He still has a good balance thanks to his incredible edges, but he doesn't get much involved in board battles, and strong defensemen have more ease stopping him. I'm not very concerned with that because, contrary to other small forward, his great skating helps him get out of tough situations and dodge his opponent. But it is one aspect to work on. Once he starts putting more mass on his frame, his small size won't even be a subject of discussion anymore. Lafrenière has a great strength that helps him win board battles and protect his puck well. Lafrenière gets the easy win in this one. Let's continue on and look at their hockey IQ. Hughes keeps his head up to read every information available to him and adapts to it quickly. Although I would like to see him open the play more often, Hughes managed to use his skill effectively. Lafrenière is the smartest 17-year-old player I've seen. He thinks the game quicker and better than anybody on the ice. He is able to make the whole opposing team think he's going for a shot and just feed his line mate with an incredible scoring chance. He does that successfully every game. He also creates great pass and go that completely mystify goalies. He just knows what play to make before getting the puck. I sometimes cough myself laughing at how ridiculous some of his plays are. Just look at these plays. Those are not ordinary for D-2 prospects. He is not a puck hog at all, as he immediately passes the puck when he sees a teammate in a better position than him. He reads the play well and can exploit breaches in the opposing defense. Lafrenière wins easily. Finally, let's look at their competitiveness. Hughes put effort to recover the puck offensively, but backchecks with less effort. Lafrenière puts effort in board battles, but still has to work on backchecking more often. I think both players have their strengths and weaknesses in this aspect, so there is no real winner. With those results, Lafrenière seems to be the better prospect. Although I would agree, I think it's a way closer battle than this visual tells us. Hughes skating alone makes him a dominant force on the ice every game, and that will still be the case at the NHL level. That said, Lafrenière's hockey IQ and vision are already elite, and any coach will die to have such a prospect on their lineup. Both players have a very similar ceiling, but Lafrenière's game is just so complete that I would love to give him the edge. However, I personally think Hughes will be more dominant at the World Junior this year with his flashy skating and stick handling, but that wasn't the initial question. Looking at the long run, I would totally select Lafrenière if both were available for my team. Anyway, who would you prefer? A flashy, exciting, skilled and generational skater, Inhugues are an amazingly smart but yet very skilled, versatile offensive juggernaut in Lafrenière. Feel free to comment on who you would select out of the two and why. I'm very curious to know your opinion. Now that I have reviewed every part of the game, I'm very excited to see them battle it out at the World Junior Championship. Subscribe for more NHL draft related videos and click here to see my past scouting report on 2019 NHL draft eligibles. I'll see you for the next one.
Fear not, here I come, you can't hide. Ready or not, here I come.